Plans forced to be scrapped to build a memorial to keep the legacy of four bikers alive. After nearly 2 years, friends say they don't have the money to build what they planned.
It's not that we're going to give up on the fallen four. We're going to make sure they're never forgotten.
Good evening. I'm Adrian Whitsett.
And I'm Melissa Fry. The group is short $184,000 for the planned memorial. A drunk driver killed Dale Aspidin, Dennis Cheney, Steve Benscoter, and Jay Bach 2 years ago along I-29 near Little Sioux as the group returned from Sturgis. KTV News Watch 7's Hannah Pickett is live.
Melissa, friends and family say this is like losing the fallen four all over again. Despite nearly 2 years of fundraising through memorial rides, golf tournaments, and t-shirts, it just wasn't enough. It's been nearly 2 years since this brotherhood was broken. Dale Aspidin, Steven Benscoter, Dennis Cheney, and their friend Jay Bach, the fallen four, killed by a drunk driver on I-29.
I don't think as a group we've ever recovered from it. Every time we go out on a ride, the guys that would be right there in front with us, they're not there anymore.
Keith Calloway organized efforts to build the Fallen Four building.
And Calloway says the Fallen Four Memorial Building, which would have stood here, was designed for much more than just remembering his friends. It was designed to increase public safety.
We were going to use it as a training facility for drunk driving awareness, drug and alcohol abuse. We had possibilities of starting motorcycle training classes there.
That dream is now broken.
It was a real difficult decision to make. It's just we couldn't garner the right support for our building.
Calloway says they needed $200,000 for the building, and 2 years of fundraising didn't come close.
About $16,000 was all.
Even though the Fallen Four won't have a building, Calloway says their message,
that drinking and driving is not necessary,
will never be broken.
Never, never. We won't let it die.
Now, Calloway says they are still trying to find a way to honor the Fallen Four with the $16,000 they've raised so far. Whether that will be a memorial or education outreach, they just haven't decided yet. Reporting live in the Newsplex, Hannah Pickett, KETV NewsWatch 7.